And hello guys, so welcome back to some more Sonic Adventure DX. So, in the last part, we actually finished the game, and I did say that that was the finale, that was the end of the Sonic Adventure DX series, and I was correct. However, I did want to make another video, which is this video, obviously, showing the extras part of Sonic Adventure, because Sonic Adventure obviously has these 7 stories, which you can play as, you can do all the characters, etc, etc, but in fact, there's a bunch of other stuff that you can do outside of this that you can just have some fun with, muck about with, and, you know, just waste some time. And it does get you more emblems, which allows you to unlock more stuff. So because of that, I do want to show all of these different kind of features before we end the series off completely. So, you can do this with any character except Super Sonic. So you want to choose either Sonic, Tails, Knuckles, Amy, Big, or E-102 Gamma. But for this one, I'm just going to choose Sonic, because why the hell not? Oh, and also, you can also view the ending again if you really, really want to, but I don't really care about that. But yeah. Anyways, so, we're going to be Sonic for this. So, you'll spawn back in Station Square after you finish the game. After you finish the game, you can go back and do all the stages again if you want to. You can go back to all the different locations and repeat every single stage if you feel like it. But I'm not going to do that. However, what you do want to do, or the first thing I want to show, is up here in Twinkle Park. I mentioned it briefly when I went through Twinkle Park as Sonic, but I never actually got to show it off. So let's go and show it off, shall we? So, like I said before, this will take you to the main stage, Twinkle Park, but we're not going to do that because we've already seen Twinkle Park. We want to go in here, which is Twinkle Circuit, which is a sub-game, or a mini-game, you could say, which is based off the whole car gimmick that you could play as in Twinkle Park. So basically, this whole mini-game is dedicated to just the whole racing car game. It's literally just well, it's Twinkle Circuit. It's literally just a racing track. Oh my god. It's just a racing track, just completely designed for each character. The tracks are the same for every character, so there's no difference in that. However, every character that you play as in this mode does have different cars, which means that they all have different controls. So, like, Sonic has the fastest car. Tails has, like, the best handling. Knuckles has, like, the best acceleration and stuff like that. So, there's different characters that you can play as that can affect what times you get. I'm just showing it off as Sonic because, I don't know, he's the main character, right? But yeah, it's nothing too exciting. It's just a standard racetrack. If you really, really enjoyed the race car levels, then this is here for you to play, I guess. It's nothing fantastic, but it's here. I might as well show it off because, well, at the end of this, I will get an emblem out of it, so I'm not gonna say no to that. But yeah, but it's not really an exciting track. It's just a simple track. There's no obstacles. There's no, there's nothing really anything different. It's got jamming music in the background, may I add. It's got good music. But apart from that, it follows the same logic, same control, same gimmick as Twinkle Park. So, yeah. I'm just gonna cut to whenever I finish this track, because like any other racetrack, it's 3 laps. So, I'm just gonna cut to when I get to the final lap and finish the race. So, I'll see you when I'm done. I'll see you then. And we're done. There we go. I didn't get the best times, but whatever. That's not that big of a deal. 55 seconds, 48 seconds, 47 seconds, 2 minutes and 31 seconds. It's okay. Nothing fantastic, but like I said, once you complete that track, you do get an emblem. I'm not sure if you get an emblem for every single character. I think once you've done it once with one character, you get it for all of them, so you don't have to do it again, so don't worry about that. But anyway, that's all I wanted to show you. Time to show you to the next thing I want to show off. Let's see. The next one is quite a big one, basically. This is probably one of the biggest features of Sonic Adventure. And in my opinion, probably the feature that probably made me spend the most time on this game. And in Sonic Adventure 2, which is the sequel to this game, obviously. Basically, this elevator here. This elevator will be accessible for every single character once you've unlocked Station Square, which you should have. I think you just literally unlock it in the first thing. But anyways, once you have access, go into the elevator as Sonic. And it will take you in here. This is what most people, if most big Sonic fans will know, this is the Chao Garden. The Chao Garden has no impact on the story. It has no benefits to being in here whatsoever. In fact, you don't ever have to come in here at all. However, the reason why I want to come in here is because this is basically a separate game on its own. Trust me, this is quite a big and in-depth part of the game, and it only gets more in-depth as you carry on. So basically, as you can see, it's a nice little garden filled with trees, a nice fountain over here. They are also, there's a black market, which we will get into in a second, and there's the Chao race. You should have seen what the Chaos are. The Chaos are the little blue cute things that we've seen in some of the cutscenes when we got sent back to the past with Takao. You can actually get them over here. So as you can see, there are eggs here that you can get. So you just pick up the egg. That's not how you pick up the egg. You go up to the egg and press X or B, whatever you want to do. While holding down B, you want to hold the control stick in a direction so you can like shake the egg or cuddle the egg. I don't really know what Sonic does, but he's sort of doing something like that. Once you've done that, just place the egg down on the floor, give it a couple of seconds, and egg should start to hatch. Yep, it's starting to hatch right now. And when you see it finally happen, you will see... don't want to do that. Yes, don't do that to your Chao. Anyways, as you can see, we get this lovely, cute, this cute, adorable little... thing. I don't even know what it's supposed to be, but yes, this is a Chao. As you can see, it's nice and adorable, it's cute, it's lovely, cuddly, huggable. But yes, it's not just there just to be cute and cuddly. There's actually things you can do with it. As you can see, when you pick it up, it has like swim, fly, run, stamina, I think it was, and power. Oh, don't want to do that. I accidentally just hit my Chao. Yeah, don't do that, by the way, just saying. But yeah, as you can see, you've got all of these different stat attributes. You can actually raise these up and level them up. To make your Chao stronger, make him faster, make him be able to swim, make him able to run, make him able to fly, etc, etc. Is there a reason for this? Well, there's sort of a reason. This all relates to the Chao race. Before we carry on to that, though, however, our other Chao just decided to hatch. But yes, if you leave the eggs in here over time, they will just hatch by themselves, so you don't have to worry about it. But if you want to do it the quick way, you can just... do what I did, shake it open and let it hatch. And as you can see, since the Chao can't swim, it's sort of drowning. So what you want to do is obviously get him out and save him. So what I want to talk about Chao. If you've ever played Tamagotchi or Neopets or anything like that, these are basically like virtual pets that Sega decided to add into this game. Like I said, this is not anything that you have to do. This is something completely optional, but I was always a big fan of this kind of pet stuff because I never had a pet when I was a child. So this was probably the closest I could ever get to taking care of a pet. It's a bit easier than taking care of a real pet. You don't have to feed it. You don't have to clean up its mess after it's done its business. You know, stuff like that. But like any other pet, you want to take care of it. You can feed it. If we can get some fruit. I'm sure you can get some fruit on the trees. Just shake off the tree. You can get some fruit. If we can do so like that. You can feed the Chao. You can pet it. You can love it. You can cuddle it. You can do all this kind of stuff just to try and make the Chao love you. And as it grows more affectionate towards you, it will grow as a Chao like any other animal would. It will eventually learn new tricks, it will learn new traits, and it's just something that's very good to pass the time, and it's just something I was really, really into. Let's just see. We'll see. Once the Chao finishes off his foods, okay, he's not very hungry apparently. But as you can see, the stamina bar did go up a bit, so as you can see, the more fruit that you feed to these Chao, the levels will go up, and once the levels go up, they will get stronger, they'll get better, etc, etc. As you can see, there was two Chao, and they'll be wandering about. Let's go to the black market. So, every time you complete a stage throughout the normal game, or throughout the story mode, you'll get rings, as we keep seeing that get built up at the end of the, the result screen. This is where you can spend your rings. So, as you can see, we can actually go buy different kinds of Chao eggs, which will produce, obviously, different colored Chao. There's different kinds of fruit here, which all give different sort of effects and different sort of attributes to your Chao. There's heart fruit, hero fruit, round fruit. These are special kind of items which you can give to your Chao as clothing. They can wear these on their heads. So you can wear a bucket on their head, an empty can, paper, pans, etc, etc. They're quite expensive, but they're just for a little cosmetic looks. You can sell items, but we don't have any items to sell, but... items being sold are obviously standard, you get money for it, blah blah blah. But yeah, one things you don't want to do to your Chao, you don't want to hit your Chao, you don't want to spin dash your Chao, you don't want to do anything that results in your Chao hating you. Is there any reason for your Chao to hate you? No, so don't do it, because it's just, that's just you being a bad person. There's no downside to your Chao hating you, it's just being a bad person. Unless you really don't like these guys, then I don't know, go crazy. This little thing here is for the Game Boy Advance, and since I'm playing this on the PC, this machine's sort of pointless. But what it can do instead, since I'm playing on the Steam PC port, if we pick up our Chao and come to this machine, since we don't have access to the Game Boy Advance, Sega sort of changed the function of this machine. You can actually name your Chao. So over here, we can name my Chao anything. So we can call him, like, I don't know. We can call him James. Why not? Fuck it. Why not? We can call him James. So you can call him anything. There's no censorship, anything. You can call him faggot. You can call him fuck. You can call him anything you want. But yeah, let's just, fuck it, I'm gonna call him, there's no reason, I don't know, it was the first name that came to my mind, okay? So yeah, once you've done that, and you'll be called James once the Chao gets spit out. There was a goodbye option. Basically, the goodbye option is just the release option, so you can release your Chao if you don't like it enough, and as you saw, I accidentally spin dashed it again. That's the problem with Sonic Adventure 1, they assigned the pickup button to the same button as the spin dash button, so you'll have times where you might accidentally spin dash your Chao and accidentally hurt it. So try to be careful about that. Yeah, it's a bit annoying. Let's see, what else can I show? Okay, yes. So I'm gonna, as you can see, there's two teleporters here, which we can't exactly do for now. But I'm gonna cut to when I get to where I can show you the next part of the Chao Garden. So I'll see you in a second. And we're back, guys. So. You want to go to Mystic Ruins, which I have cut to, luckily, all the way over here, and you want to go back to, if you remember where we got our power-up for Knuckles, you want to come over here. You can come over here with any character, but like I said, I'm doing this with Sonic. You want to come over here, and you want to take this minecart. This minecart will take you to somewhere special. And yeah, like I said, this is completely optional, but this will take you to another Chao Garden. There are multiple Chao Gardens in this game, which is pretty cool. They all have the same function. It's literally just cosmetic design, so it's literally take your pick whatever Chao Garden you like. I personally prefer Station Square's Chao Garden, but this one is really nice as well, I have to admit. It's a really big and very nice open area, which I think is pretty cool. They do obviously come with two Chao eggs as per usual with every Chao Garden. So let's hatch these as well and see what kind of Chao we get. I never explained it either, but obviously, Chao's come in a bunch of different colors, different textures, different kind of personalities, but they also come with different facial features. So hopefully I can get a Chao here that has a different facial feature, which I can show you. Because every Chao, literally, as you can see here, yeah, this one here, let's pick him up without hurting it. As you can see, this one has a sad face on it, so all these Chao's have different features. They can have different eyes, they can have different facial features, they can have different colors. And yeah, there's a lot of depth into this, a lot more than I ever really expected, but it's all here. Let's open this one. Oh, also, if you want to be a really, really mean person, there are other ways to open Chao eggs. You can, one, leave it on the ground so it hatches by itself. You can do the hugging technique, or if you want to be a right dickhead, you can actually just chuck the egg onto the wall and the Chao will hatch that way. I recommend not doing that because the Chao will probably not like you for doing so. But you can do that and you'll get another Chao. As you can see, this one has a happy face, so this one's kind of generic, but yeah. Now this is where the teleporters come in. So, once you've accessed all the three different kind of Chao Gardens, you can actually use the teleporters to teleport to each respective Chao Garden, in case you don't want to walk to every single one. As you saw, there's actually our third Chao Garden, which we will now go and show, so I'll see you when I get there. Okay, and we're back, guys. So we're back at Mystic Ruins. You want to now go to the egg carrier. So if you don't know how to get to the egg carrier after it's crashed into the ocean, you want to go into Mystic Ruins. You want to come into this little boat bit, and you want to stand on this raft, and this will automatically take you to the egg carrier. We have already done this with E102 Gamma, but I just wanted to show you again in case you guys forgot. So once you're at the egg carrier, you want to now get inside the egg carrier, which hopefully I can do. Get in here. Just take this yellow pod thing, and this should take you into the inner part of the egg carrier. Once you're in here, you will see a room that we've walked past many, many times. It'll be this room here. This room will have a bunch of button combinations, which you think, what do I have to do here? So you want to, if you want to have hints, even though it's pretty self-explanatory. If I can. Okay. Nope. Yes. That's a thing, by the way. I just said. The secret passage to open the door is Eggman. So, obviously, if you know how to spell Eggman, this is how you spell it. You want to stand on the panels that spell out Eggman, obviously. It's pretty simple. It's nothing hard at all. And once you've done this, it'll open this door, which will take you to this little teleporter here. Stand on this teleporter. And voila. For some reason, I don't know why, they never explained it, but Eggman has his own private Chao Garden in his own airship. I don't know why, and it does make you wonder what happens to the Chao when the airship crashes. Do these guys, like, suffer any trauma or anything? I don't know. But this is the third and final egg garden, Chao Garden. It's actually really, really nice as well. I think this one and Station Square's one is really, really nice looking. It looks really awesome. It's just a massive tropical paradise. It's actually pretty cool. But as you can see, there are two more Chao eggs which we can hatch. Let's do that. I'm just going to open this one by doing this. It works. Oh, okay. You have to hit it off a surface. I mean, you have to hit it off a wall if you want it to hatch. So, yeah, you have to want to do that. Okay. There we go. What kind of Chao did I get here? Another happy one. Nothing special. Over here. Let's break this one. Ugh. And as you can see, this one has a different facial expression. As you can see, it's got an evil, cheesy, smiley grin face. So yeah, if you're not happy with the facial expressions of these Chao, unfortunately, there is no way to reset and try to get another one since it's all preset as soon as the game loads in your Chao save data. So if you want to get another Chao, you're just going to either hope that you can buy another one from the black market, or actually, yeah, that's the only way you're ever going to get another Chao. So if you don't get a face that you like, you're sort of shit out of luck. I'm actually going to include a website which shows you all the different kind of facial expressions, all the really, really in-depth stuff about Chao in the description, because there is a lot of stuff about Chao that I can never explain in one video. If I was to explain this all in one video, this video would be over an hour long, and this video is going to be long enough as it is. So I'm not going to do that, I'm just going to shove it into the description. If you guys are curious about this game more, then you can have a look for yourself, because not everyone is interested in this section. I was, luckily, so I sort of went and learned all of this stuff myself, but I know there are people out there that don't really give two shits about Chao, and because of that, I don't really want to bore people that don't care about that stuff, so I'm just going to link, put it in the description, so you guys can see if you guys are curious or not. Anyways, on to the next part about Chao, so I'll see you in a second. And we're back once again, so as you can see, we are now not in a Chao Garden, we are back in Emerald Coast. I don't know why, I just chose a stage out of randomly habit. You can choose any other stage, but the reason why I'm here is still Chao related. So as you can see, which you should have seen plenty of times before actually, you may have seen those glowing animal things that are like in those green orbs as every time you destroy an enemy. Those are related to Chao, so the only reason I chose this stage is just so I can get some animals so I can show them off. So as you can see, when you kill a Chao, or not kill a Chao, don't kill Chao's, just saying. Every time you kill an enemy, those little animals that come out of the robots, you want to try and collect as many of those as possible. It doesn't show me, bugger. Every time you collect an animal, it will pop in the bottom right corner briefly, just for a couple seconds or so. Hopefully I can show it if I can get another animal. I kind of chose a bad stage actually, because there's not many animals, there's not many robots that spawn in this stage, so kind of fucked up there, but I did get a few animals, so that should be enough. Yeah, so we're just going through this stage like normal. Okay, I fucked up. Okay, I can think. So yeah, every time you pick it up, it doesn't actually show you, but you do pick up the animal. So every time you pick up the animal, you can now actually give them to your Chao. The reason why you want to get those is so you can give them to your Chao and they'll get attribute bonuses. They'll level up, they'll get stronger. This is how you get your Chao to level up. Apart from feeding it fruit, you can give it animals and it will, get the attribute of the animal. So every animal you pick up will be different. Like I said before, the website will have everything you need to know about these animals, because every animal does give a special attribute. So for example, if you pick up like a rabbit, it will give speed. If you pick up a gorilla, it will give power or strength. If you pick up a vulture, it will give flight, etc, etc. There's so many different animals in this game. It's like, there's a rabbit here. This should give speed if you give it to a Chao. And yeah, that's how you level up your Chao and make them stronger. That's all I wanted to show you guys. I'm going to cut back to the Chao Garden for when I can show you me feeding these animals to the Chao. So I'll see you in a second. Okay, and we're back. So, managed to get those animals from Emerald Coast. Now, every time you get those animals, you come to the Chao Garden and Sonic will just sort of ship them out of nowhere. And you see all these animals sparkling, looking lovely, lovely. So we've got a couple otters, we've got some seals, we've got rabbit, penguins, and stuff like that. So all you got to do is literally pick up the animal, go up to one of the Chao, whichever one you want may be, literally give it to the Chao, it will do it by default, and as you can see, it will go up some levels. And every time you actually give a Chao an animal, it will actually take some of its features. So as you saw, I gave it a seal, and it took the seal's flippers, I guess? So let's see what happens if I take it, give it an otter. Okay, this is not an otter, it's a seal, but let's give it an otter, see what happens. So otter will increase swim. It got its ears, apparently, it's not too bad. What about a penguin? Penguin should give swim and fly, right, since it's a bird. It does indeed. It even gives a bit of run as well. As you can see, it levels up. It's now level 1 swimming. Let's keep feeding it more and see what we can do. Let's give it another seal. But basically, you can keep doing this over and over and over again to level up your Chao. And your Chao will get some cool features while it's at it. So it's quite nice. Yeah, this is how you basically get your Chao up to the max level, which is level 99. The reason for doing all of this, we're going to do that just now. So, even though I have barely fed my Chao anything and he barely knows any traits, I can still show it off, I guess. Did it get to level 2 in swimming? No, it's like level 1 with like a tiny bit. Okay. I'll give it his otter. This should be enough, right? This should level up, right? Yeah, level 2. Nice. I'll give it his rabbit too, since it's here. We should get the rabbit ears, hopefully. That'll be quite cool. Okay. Yeah, these animals are a bit weird. They're a bit buggy. They sort of hover about doing whatever. Okay, I'm not giving it to you. I'm giving it to you. Give it to James. As you see, it gets the bunny ears, the bunny paws. It's quite cool. It looks quite nice. But yes, now that I've done all of that, let's now show what the whole point of all of this is. So you want to come in here. This is the Chao race. So, the Chao race. There's a bunch of different races, but because I haven't done any of them, we only have the beginner race. The more races you win, you're going to unlock like 10 more races. There's literally like, there's like 15 races in the whole game. But since we've only just started this section of the game, we only have one Chao. And because of that, one Chao and one race. Oh, four courses in this one race section. So, yeah. So all these courses are different. Some are longer than others. Some are specified in running and power and agility. We're just going to show off the Pearl course. Every race is different. You compete against other Chao, which are obviously controlled by the computer. But yeah, this is the reason why you want to make your Chao stronger, because you get this little minigame section, you don't really do anything, it's literally just a little simulator to see your Chao and how well he does. As you can see, we are number one, and currently we are in third place. You get to see your Chao, you don't get to do anything, you can select what Chao you want to spectate. I don't know why you want to watch other Chao, since you obviously want to watch your own Chao, right? So yeah. The stronger your Chao is, the better the art race is. Since my Chao is quite weak, as you can see, my Chao is barely doing anything. But it's second place right now. So that's not too bad, right? But yeah, as you can see, it's literally just a race to the finish. Some races are longer than others. This one's just literally a sprint finish from one end to the other. So as you can see, I say it's a sprint race. But they're crawling their way slowly. Very, very slowly. But yeah. This is how these Chao races work. Quite short, but yeah. My Chao got top 3, which is pretty good. It came 3rd place. Unfortunately, you do not get prizes for 3rd place. You want to win these races because you get medals. You unlock more races, obviously. And it's just cool because you get prizes, like toys and stuff for your Chao that can play with. But we're not doing all of that. I just wanted to show that little race off. If you want to look at the other kind of races you can do, check it out for yourself, because I'm not here to display every single race, because those races are quite long. Some races last up to like 2 or 3 minutes, so they are quite long races. I just happened to choose the shortest one, which is pretty cool. Anyways, that's all I actually wanted to show off about Chao's. If you want to know more about Chao's, like I said, you want to check the description, because there's a bunch of stuff that you can still learn about with Chao. Chao's can evolve, they can get better, they can grow up, they can change color. It's like Pokemon in a sense, if you want to put it that way. It's a bit like Pokemon. But yeah, I spent hours playing with these Chao. I loved doing this when I was a child. It was a good way to pass the time, and there's just so much depth into it. So yeah, like I said, if you want to learn more about it, then check it in the description below. And yeah, the video is not over, guys. There is still one or two more things I want to show off before we are done. So without further ado, let's cut to the next one. And we're back, guys. So I said I was going to move on to something else, but I completely forgot about this part here. So this is still related to Chao. There are actually special eggs that are scattered all around the adventure fields, which you can get, which allows you to unlock special type of Chao that you can only get by doing this, actually. So if you want to get these special Chao, I highly recommend doing so. So I came over here because this is the first place you want to go. You want to grab this little object here, which ironically looks exactly like a Chao egg. Unfortunately, it is not a Chao egg, so do not take this to the Chao garden because it will do absolutely nothing. But what you want to do is enter this house here. This is the mayor's house or whatever else is. You want to come in here and you want to see this thing here. This is a Chao egg. However, as soon as you pick up this egg, the door closes, as you can see. And obviously, because it's closed, you can't do anything. You can't get out, you can't get back in, etc, etc. The only way for you to get out is to put something else back onto the pedestal, which is why you wanted to bring this little stone in here. You want to put this stone on the thing, it will allow you to open the door, and you can walk out with this lovely egg. And obviously, if we can take this egg to the Chao garden, which we will do just here, we will see what kind of Chao it may be. This is a very, very rare Chao, may I add. You can only get this Chao through the adventure field. I think there are other places you can get it, but this is the easiest way you can get it, because this is a very, very rare Chao. And once you've gotten this Chao, you cannot ever get it again unless you restart your save file or something. But yeah, as you can see, when you enter this garden, the Chao egg sort of turns into a better color. And as you can see, it is gold. So this is a gold Chao egg. So obviously, gold Chao's are super cool and rare, right? And that is correct. This is a super rare Chao. So let's hatch it and see what we get. We're not going to do anything with this Chao, but I just wanted to show it off because it's gold and it's shiny and it looks awesome. And as you see, we've got a shiny gold Chao, which is pretty sick. Yeah, look at it. It looks awesome. Yeah, it will always be this color no matter what you do. It will forever stay gold. And yeah, it's a pretty unique color. So I'd highly recommend picking this one up because it's there for the taking. Anyways, time to move on to the next Chao egg that you can get. So I'll see you when I'm there. Okay, and we're back at Mystic Ruins again. So in case you haven't noticed already, or you're going to see a pattern, basically there's three eggs that you can get throughout the whole game, which are all in each major adventure field. There's obviously the one Mystic Ruins, one at the Egg Carrier, and there's one at Station Square. So obviously the second one we want to go to is the one at Mystic Ruins. Basically, you want to come down here and you see this little, I don't know what this is. You want to come in here and you want to push it forward. What this basically does is that it will move that little lever, rock, stone, ruin thing, which is near that waterfall. And you'll see that something dropped below it. And as you can see, something has dropped. It is another egg-shaped color thing. So yes, if you saw that our first egg was gold, you could probably guess what kind of colored egg this one will be. So once it goes to the sides of the ocean, not lake, ocean, lake, whatever you want to call it, you want to pick it up, and obviously you want to take it to, you want to take it to the Chao garden, obviously, so we're going to do that just now. There we go. Right. It's this way. You want to enter here. No, this is not the way. This is the fucking Windy Valley. We don't want to go to Windy Valley. You want to go down over here. You want to go in here. Then get on the minecart. And yeah. Oh, if you also for some reason lose the egg, like you accidentally throw it or it glitches out and disappears, don't worry. It will just respawn back into its normal set location. And you just gotta exit the map and come back and it will just magically reappear again. So don't you worry about that. But as you see, let's hatch this egg and see what kind of Chao we get. Obviously, this is a silver Chao. We've got a gold, we've got a silver. What do you think the third one's going to be? And I can tell you now, it's not what you're thinking it's going to be. As you can see, we have got our third Chao. It's actually got a different facial feature. As you can see, it's got a smiley eye face, whatever you want to call it. So it will always be permanently have that happy smiley faced eyes. So yeah, that's pretty cool. Anyways, now we want to go to the egg carrier, which we are going to do now. Let's just take the shortcut using the teleporter. Right, we want to come over here and we want to get out of here. Where's the exit portal? There we go. You want to take the exit portal to come out so we can get our third and final egg. You may have seen it before. If you have sharp eyes, you may have seen this egg or you'll know where it already is, actually. So if you do, then good for you. Let's hopefully I can find it. Okay. Bye, guys. So, bit stupid of me, turns out that you can only get the black, I've already spoiled what the egg color is going to be, it's a black egg. The next egg, you can only get it as either E102 Gamma or Amy, apparently, because it is actually, I think it's this one here? Which one is it? No, you have to switch, right? Yeah, you have to switch, and then you enter here. You can only enter here as E102 Gamma or Amy, because this is the prison cell. You obviously have this little minigame with the hammer thing, we're not going to do that. But yeah, so you see this prison cell, which we saw at the very beginning of the game with Amy being captured by Zero, whatever it was. As you can see, it is a black egg. It's inside here. All you gotta do is literally just, you just gotta stand on the switch, right? There you go. You stand on the switch, and it opens, and as you can see, the black egg is here. And then obviously, like any other egg, we gotta take it to the Chao Garden. So let's go and do just that. Just ignore the minigame. We're not gonna do that, because there's no need for us to do that. And of course, let's go and take it to the Chao Garden. Unfortunately, Amy is super duper slow, which is really, really annoying. But, I don't think I mentioned this, but, you don't have to worry about, the Chao save data, because the Chao save data does share between characters, so whatever you do with Sonic, for example, if you decide to level up your Chao like two levels on Sonic, it will carry over to Amy as well. Everything will carry over in terms of data, in terms of progression, completing races, etc, etc. However, the Chao does not necessarily mean it will love the next character. So if it really, really loves Sonic, for example, it will not necessarily mean it will love Amy, Tails, or Knuckles. So you want to make sure that the Chao loves every single character that you decide to play as. So only play as the characters that you really, really like. So if you like playing as Sonic, then play as Sonic. If you like playing as Tails, then play as Tails, etc, etc. Because if you decide to play as a bunch of different characters, you're going to have to build up friendship with every single one of them, which takes a long time, so don't bother. I usually just tend to do it with just Sonic, because Sonic's like the best character because he's the fastest, and he's got the best mobility. But yes, as you can see, we've got our last and final Chao, which is the Black Chao. Nothing special about this Chao. He's just a black color, nothing super duper special. But this is, like I said, the only way you can get a Black Chao in the game, so if you want a Black Chao, then here you go. And that's it, guys. Now we have finally completed everything about Chao. Now I can finally move on to the next thing, and will be the final thing of the video, and then we can finally finish off the series once and for all. So without further ado, I will see you guys in the next bit. And we're back, guys. So we're back on the menu screen. As you can see, there is Adventure Mode, Trial Mode, and Mission Mode. You can actually do Mission Mode as early as you can from, like, after you complete Sonic Story. I think Mission Mode automatically unlocks, but I decided to leave it until the end of the... end of the game, because it felt necessary. I don't think I've ever showed Trial Mode, but Trial Mode is just pretty much, you can call it Replay Mode. If you choose any character, let's go back to Sonic as an example. Trial Mode just allows you to replay every single stage. If you don't want to just go through the adventure fields and walk through them individually, you can just access them quickly here through a menu screen. As you can see, it tells you your best score, your best time, the most rings you obtained, and it tells you how many emblems you can get from each stage. So as you can see, there's 3 emblems you can get from every stage, depending on what ranks you get. I've already described how you get them. Basically, they're just different challenges which get harder and harder as you complete them. And yeah, I've already showed them before, so I'm not going to show them again. There's one for every single character. You've got the sub-games, which is, like I said, just the same as all the other stuff. Sub-games are just the mini-game modes. So there's Sky Chase, which is the playing section. There's Ice Cap, which was the snowboarding section. Sand Hill, which is the snowboarding section, but for the desert area. Twinkle Circuit, which is obviously the car mission we just did. And then there's Boss. Boss is a boss rush, basically. If you decide to do Boss, you can fight every single boss in a row with one life. You can't die. And yeah, if you die, obviously it's game over. You've got to start from the beginning. But it's just a boss rush mode if you want to do that, if you really, really like the bosses. But apart from that, there's no really other reason to do it. And yeah, and like I said, there's one for every single character. So if you want to do that, then go free. But that's not why I came here to show. I'm here to show Mission Mode. So Mission Mode is shared with all 6 of these characters, but it gets a bit more detailed. So anyways, select the character and you'll get chucked right into the adventure field screen. You'll be thinking, what the hell is going on here? You want to know what's going on? I will show you. As you can see, there's a little card key thing here. Once you stand in the vicinity of this card key, it will give you a mission. Bring the man who's standing in front of the hamburger shop. So that is what we have to do. So tell us where we have to drop the hamburger man. If you don't know who the hamburger man is, he's over here. So he's this guy, he's not really a dude. He's like this mannequin guy. You gotta pick this guy up. And obviously, take him to that spot, which the mission told us to do. So let's go ahead and do just that. So let's go. So yeah, this is a whole completely separate game mode, which it's okay, it's not great, but it's extra stuff that you can do. But obviously, once you've dropped or completed the mission, you'll say mission clear. And yeah, that's kind of it. If you press start and you press mission, it will give you a list of all the missions you can do. There is a total of 60 missions. It is shared with every single character, like I said. However, it's color-coded to whatever character can complete what mission. You have to find the mission first before you can do it, though, by the way. They'll be scattered all around the adventure fields and all around the actual stages themselves. So you want to actually replay all the stages and start looking around for all of these missions. So as you can see, there's the first one, which was Sonic's. This one will be Sonic's. That's Sonic's. That's Tails. That's Knuckles. Amy. That will be Gamma's. That's Biggs. And yeah, so obviously, you want to complete these missions with each respective character. Once you've completed all 60, your reward is literally an emblem. Yes, you literally just get an emblem. However, you do actually unlock other stuff, which are basically just emulator games. Basically, every time you complete, I think it's every 10 missions, you unlock an old-fashioned Sega Mega Drive game. So every time you complete, like, 10 missions, you unlock, like, Sonic the Hedgehog 1 from the Sega Mega Drive. You unlock Sonic Labyrinth. You unlock Sonic Drift. You know, the very, very old Sonic games from, like, the 1990s. It's quite cool. It gives you a nice flashback. Unfortunately, I won't be showing that in my video because that would mean I would have to complete all these missions and they're really, really boring and tedious. Yeah, trust me. It's a cool idea, but they're not really fun or exciting. But yeah, I just wanted to show this to you guys. So if you want to do these missions, then go feel free to do so. I mean, obviously, if you want 100% complete the game, you're going to have to. But I'm not going to do that. I just wanted to show you these guys. So obviously, you want to complete all 60 for the emblem and you want to unlock those games if you really, really want to play the old Sonic games, even though you could literally just import it through an emulator. But hey, that's none of my business. As you can see, there's actually a mission up there. Let's try and grab it anyway. Even though we're not going to do it, we might as well grab it. Come up here. What's our mission? Mission 28. During the morning traffic, use the fountain to get the balloon. So yeah, all these missions have vague descriptions. You won't actually understand what those mean unless you have an idea. I have an idea. The mission 28 is with Sonic. It's saying during the morning traffic. Okay, the description's a bit dodgy. Basically, what it said was during the morning traffic, you want to go grab a balloon. Basically, that's kind of implying you have to go to Speed Highway. If you remember, there's a morning section at the end of Speed Highway. That's where you got to go if you want to go complete the mission. I'm not going to do that for you guys, but like I said, if you want to go and do them, then have fun, you know. Some of these are quite fun. Some of these are a bit boring and tedious. Take your pick, I guess. If you want to know all the missions, just Google it. There'll be a list on like the Sonic Wiki or something like that, or a strategy guide. So if you want to know all the missions, then feel free to do so. But yeah, guys, that will be the end. I just wanted to show everything that I wanted to show. I've managed to show off them all, so I'm pretty happy to do so, guys. Thank you guys again for watching. If you guys liked the video, leave a like, leave a comment, all that jazz. If you didn't like it, leave a comment also telling me why so I can get better for next time. But I finally showed off everything I wanted to show off. I showed off all the sub-games, I showed off the mission mode, and I showed off all the Chao features. These are all features that are completely optional. You never have to do this if you ever want to. Unless you want to 100% complete the game, there's no reason to do these extra missions or these extra optional mini-games or features. But they're nice to have. I mean, it's nice that Sega decided to implement these just to add a bit more diversity than just the standard story mode stuff. And it kind of pads the game out. Gives you a bit more time to play on the game. But yeah, I only really like the Chao game mode more than anything else. I never really did mission mode because I wasn't really a fan. I did trial mode every now and then to try and get those emblems, but I wasn't a massive fan on it. But yeah, that's all I wanted to show you guys. Thank you guys again for watching. This will be the last video. I really hope you enjoyed this series, guys. I really hope you enjoyed Sonic Adventure DX, because as well, I did. I love Sonic Adventure DX, so hope you guys enjoyed it as well. Thank you guys again for watching, and of course, see you guys later. Peace out.